This past summer was the hottest on record in 126 years in the contiguous United States. To shield against rising temperatures, many cities across the country are looking to trees, which have been shown to cool the air by as much as 10 degrees. NewsHour Weekend special correspondent Karla Murthy reports from Cleveland on that city's effort to increase its tree canopy.
We do want to talk about the importance of trees, how to maintain them, just give you some tips and tricks and a few pointers.
On a late summer day in August, residents in the Old Brooklyn neighborhood of Cleveland have come out to learn about trees.
Most people like to plant them and forget them. You have to really baby them over the first 3 to 4 year mark, then they start to take off, and then it's...
Their neighborhood community organization will be planting 100 trees this fall after receiving a grant from the county. To get a free tree in their yard, homeowners have to attend one of these workshops.
You know, ultimately, these trees need to get in the ground. So
it's all part of a citywide effort to dramatically increase the tree canopy.
Cleveland was once proudly known as the forest city, but since the 1950s, it's lost about half its tree canopy. Today, it continues to lose nearly 100 acres of tree cover every year.
So we don't have a lot of trees to begin with, and we're losing them faster than we're planting them currently.
Sandra Albro is the director of community partnerships at Holden Forest and Gardens, one of the founding organizations of the Cleveland Tree Coalition, which has grown to over 40 public, private, and community groups since it was formed in 2015.
Currently, we are at about 18% tree cover for the city, so that means that slightly under one-fifth of the city is shaded by trees.
And what is the ideal number to hit in terms of percentage?
In urban areas, benefits really start to hit a tipping point at around 30% tree cover.
Those benefits include keeping neighborhoods cooler, lowering energy bills, and absorbing heat-trapping carbon dioxide from the air. Trees also capture stormwater runoff, improve air quality, and increase property values. To reap those benefits, the coalition developed a plan to reach 30% tree cover across the city by the year 2040. Reaching that goal is more complicated than just planting more trees and will take a massive citywide effort.
So this is an aerial shot of Cleveland.
Albro says the city should first focus on areas that need trees the most.
Here you can see a map of Cleveland with, in terms of urban heat stress. And in the central area, where you don't have as many trees, so the lighter green here, we also see that those areas tend to be the hottest already and are at most risk for, you know, deadly temperatures with climate change.
That central area is where Samira Malone lives and works.
I actually lived right over here.
Malone is a neighborhood planning manager at Midtown Cleveland, a member of the Tree Coalition. The Midtown neighborhood near downtown has a 6.5% tree canopy, much lower than the city's average of 18%. That lack of tree cover contributes to what's called the heat island effect.
So we're standing in a heat island.
We are.
It is only like 10 o'clock in the morning. I mean, what does this feel like right now?
It feels very hot. It feels very soupy to be in my business casual. But yeah, this is the reality of so many residents. This area, folks use a lot of public transportation. So people are walking up and down the street to get to the bus. People are walking to work up and down these areas that leave very few refuge for actual shade.
In fact, heat islands in downtown Cleveland can be up to 20 degrees hotter than in suburban areas with more trees just outside the city limits. Malone says the lack of trees also correlates to many health issues. Residents in this area have some of the highest rates of asthma and heart disease. She says these disparities reflect a broader pattern of racial discrimination and decades of disinvestment.
Specifically in our neighborhood, the census tracts that have the lowest level of tree canopy also have the highest percentage of Black residents, and that's not something that's just a coincidence.
Malone has been developing a tree plan, which will be implemented this fall. Her organization was recently awarded a grant from the county to plant 175 trees per year for the next 2 years.
The thing that's beautiful about this project is that we're not just haphazardly throwing trees in the ground, right? Like I mentioned before, there's been an economic disinvestment in tree infrastructure in Black and brown neighborhoods. So this is really an act of racial restorative justice.
Just east of Midtown, a tree planting event is being held by the Famicos Foundation, a community nonprofit. Today, four trees are being planted in a vacant lot to create an outdoor learning center for the school across the street. Over the last 2 years, Famicos and its partners have planted over 250 trees throughout the three neighborhoods it serves.
So the students will be able to come out and help watch them grow.
Erica Burnett is the director of community building and engagement. She says getting trees in the ground is actually the easy part. Taking care of them afterwards is a lot more challenging, especially during the first year when trees have to be watered regularly.
Each tree had to get 5 gallons of water after planting, and we had to do that repeatedly. So we're like opening up hydrants, filling up buckets, and walking buckets literally up and down the street to water trees. So I was like, oh, this is a lot of work.
Burnett says part of their efforts to increase the city's tree canopy is to encourage residents to plant trees in their own yards. But all that work and the cost for watering and pruning trees are a big concern, especially for the many low-income families that live in the area.
It's about basic needs and basic survival. If I have to choose between food on my table versus a tree, I'm going to choose food on my table. So that's one of the biggest struggles, is to get people to take on new trees.
While yards may not be as accessible, there's no shortage of vacant lots like where this tree planting is taking place. In fact, there are over 30,000 of them across the city.
This is the perfect piece of land for trees, and there are little pockets like this all over Cleveland that we can put a lot of trees on.
Lizzie Swords is an urban forester with the Western Reserve Land Conservancy, another founding member of the Tree Coalition. This city-owned lot, known as Jackrabbit Hill, had been vacant for over 20 years. Last year, the Land Conservancy cleaned up the site and planted 85 trees here.
Elm trees, I was really excited about putting here. They're fast growing, they're native, they provide great wildlife habitat, and they cast awesome shade, provide really good canopy cover.
Decades from now, this baby elm tree could grow into a fully mature tree like this one.
Tackling these bigger projects is what's going to help us get to our canopy goals rather than planting in one tree in a yard. And I do think those are important, but these are the projects where we'll see canopy grow.
When people think about trees, you think about tree planting and how gratifying that is to plant a new tree. But what we've learned is that it's just as important to preserve the existing canopy, the mature tree canopy.
Jenny Spencer is a city council person on the west side of Cleveland. She created a tree canopy steering committee for her ward. Despite efforts to plant more trees, the committee organized a walk for residents to learn about the loss of trees in the Detroit Shoreway neighborhood.
There are two areas where trees were currently planted all the way up until 2016, and those are now gone. So,
a variety of factors contribute to tree loss. There's disease and weather-related losses. Utility and infrastructure projects also contribute to the loss of trees.
Really, anytime you hear concrete work, sidewalks, curbs, kind of the alarm bell should go off. When you damage a tree root in a certain way, it can lead to decline that can't be reversed, and ultimately the tree needs to be removed.
But she says there are simple measures the city has done with very few resources to mitigate that damage. In 2018, the city passed an ordinance to put tree protections in place during development projects.
Had you ever thought about sidewalks?
Sidewalks had to be replaced during a gas line replacement in Spencer's ward and were re-poured 6 inches narrower to protect the trees.
I mean, it's so minimal.
It's so minimal, and yet the city of Cleveland's urban forester said, yeah, that will really help.
And this was something that didn't cost any extra money, right?
No, I mean, it was like this aha moment where everyone realized this is so easy, why hadn't we thought of it before?
Since the Tree Coalition began, the city of Cleveland has committed $1 million each year for the next 10 years towards maintaining existing trees and planting new trees. But according to the Cleveland Tree Plan, achieving 30% tree cover will require not only preserving the existing canopy, but planting over 300,000 new trees in the next decade.
It just seems like a huge undertaking and a monumental goal to reach. I mean, how feasible is it?
The number is daunting, for sure. But having a number has forced us to have very realistic conversations about what it will really take. I think it's important to confront that, but not let it stop us from continuing to work on the problem.